most presentations are boring. To make yours better, start using 3D. Nobody knows how to use it, so you immediately stand out. So how do we find those 3D objects? They are already there. If you go to Insert tab, 3D models, stock models. Lots of models are available, static ones and animated ones. So let's take a static model and see what happens. The first thing you should do is click on the model. You get a separate menu. In that, we have a gallery or live tiles, as we call it, which shows you existing views. Hover over each one of them and choose the one most relevant for you. Of course, these are not static views. If you want to change, you can just hover on the object and rotate it freely exactly the way you want, because after all, it's a 3D object. We have another one called pan and zoom, where you get a zoom button here and up down will allow you to zoom in. Click on the format dialog to get precise control over the rotation and the camera angles. 3D objects have special animations. We have one entry and one exit and three emphasis animations. First, I'm going to open the animation pane so that we can see the actions happening. First, I'll apply arrive and then I'll also add leave. Appearing, it also rotates a little and same thing happens while it is going away. Simple, elegant and effective. If you want to highlight a product from all angles, turntable is the way to go. So select the object, click on turntable, and before you run it, look at the options, effect options. We can choose the direction in which it will turn. By default, it is a full spin, but you can customize it. Does it start and end smoothly? So this is the default turntable effect. It actually rotates the object in 360 degrees, so audience can get a complete view of all aspects of the object. Now, of course, depending on how you are using it, you may want it to repeat. So again, go to effect options, go to timing and say repeat either n number of times or until the end of the slide. Rotation 360 degrees takes 20 seconds, but you can increase or decrease it depending on what is the purpose. A swing effect is an oscillating effect. You can control how much oscillation happens by using subtle, moderate or strong. You also have smooth start, smooth end. Once in a while, you can use the jump and turn emphasis animation to attract attention to an item. To get more models, go to Sketchfab, create a free login there, search for Microsoft. And of course, there are many free as well as paid objects available from professionals. Here is a model of space shuttle created by Microsoft. But you're not limited to all this. You can create your own 3D objects right there within Windows. Go to Start menu, search for 3D Paint and create a new project. What you get is a canvas. So let's create a simple 3D text object. Click on text, click on 3D text, and simply type the text and finalize the object. And once you're done, generally you don't want this canvas to be visible, so click on canvas, say do not show canvas, then say file, save as, and two things you have to save: the project itself, and in order to use this in PowerPoint, again go to the menu, again save as 3D model, and this time choose GLB. And now this GLB file can be added into PowerPoint with all the effects which we have just seen. The best thing I have kept for the last. This is a simple 3D model of a question mark, but I want to make it more interesting. And I don't want to use any of the existing animations. I want to rotate this in such a way that initially the audience doesn't know this is a question mark. I'm going to just make it like this and smaller. Now I'm going to duplicate the slide. And in this slide, I'm going to rotate it and at the same time enlarge it as well. And then duplicate this slide again, enlarge it a little more, and then bring it exactly the way I want. At this stage, these are just three independent slides and I have nothing to do with each other. But the magic comes when you select the second and third slide and apply the morph transition. It's amazing. It understands the beginning and ending position and automatically fills in the blanks. So 3D objects and morph is an unbeatable combination. I'm sure you found this useful, so you know what to do. But how do you deliver presentations more impactfully? That's also important. I have a video for that as well. Have a look. That's it for now. Thank you.